Hey everyone! Alright, so this is my first official pregnancy vlog. I'm still in complete shock that I'm even making these vlogs now and that I'm pregnant. It is so surreal. It just doesn't seem real at all. So yeah, definitely still in shock, but welcome to week 5. I didn't do a 4-week update just because I was still waiting for my beta numbers, and so I thought I would just start at week 5 and just kind of go from there. So I'm just going to dive right in, so this isn't a super long video because I have 2 weeks, well, like a whole cycle and 2 weeks to fit into this one video. So here we go, and I have some notes, so if you see me looking down, that's what that is. So gotten a lot of questions of like what Jason and I did the month that we got pregnant. So I'll start with that. Jason and I decided in September that we were not going to do in vitro in January, that we were going to postpone it till January 2014 instead. But we were going to continue to try naturally. Because, you know, we still want to get pregnant, but we're just not ready to fork out $10,000. So what we did instead was we stopped drinking, which we have done in the past, like completely eliminated alcohol altogether. That's more for Jason than it is for myself, but we both, nonetheless, don't drink whatsoever, because alcohol is really not good for sperm. So that was one thing that we did, and we've been not drinking since just the end of September, I think, or the middle of September. And then also what we decided to do was, my husband in the past has taken Fertilaid for men, however, I've never taken Fertilaid for women just because there was nothing wrong with me, like in my cycles, so I didn't feel the need to take the Fertilaid. And it can be expensive, especially if you're doing it for a long period of time, you know, it can add up in price. So we've only ever done Fertilaid for men to help with Jason's sperm, and we have seen results in semen analysis that the Fertilaid does help with count, motility, and morphology, so we thought we'd give that another go. But just on top of it, because I haven't been taking a prenatal vitamin in a while, I thought that I would take Fertilaid for women just to see, you know, what kind of an effect it had on me. The first month that I took it, it made my cycle really short, made it 22 days long, which is abnormal. I mean, I guess I'm not 100% sure that it is from the Fertilaid, because sometimes I do have short cycles, so it's just kind of coincidental, I guess. But the second month that I was taking it, I got pregnant. So I don't know if, you know, the combination of, you know, Jason taking the Fertilaid for men kind of helping his fertility out, and me taking the Fertilaid for women helping my fertility out, you know, just giving me an extra boost, and those two combinations was just the right formula for us. But nonetheless, that's what we did. I took ovulation tests, but I knew when I was ovulating anyways, and we didn't really have timed intercourse. We sort of just did it when we wanted to, but it just sort of happenstance that it was around the right day. I remember, you know, that we BD'd this one morning, and I woke up like later and took a ovulation test, and it was positive. I was like, oh, well, that was, you know, just coincidental, because I didn't think I was going to get a positive till the following day, so I guess that's what worked. But yeah, that's what we did. Basically cut out drinking altogether and took Fertilaid for men and women. And if that's not a commercial for Fertilaid, I don't know what is. What else? How we found out. Let's see. Every single month, maybe 2 days before I get my period, I spot. I always have done, and, you know, it's just kind of a little clue, oh, hey, AF is coming. But the past, like, 2 months, before I got pregnant, I was starting to spot on 8 days past ovulation, which is really early. I was starting to get concerned, and I thought, well, you know, maybe in the new year I'll go to the doctor and just say, hey, you know, maybe you can help me figure out what's going on with this. So the cycle that we got pregnant, I was feeling a little bit lightheaded, but that's not really out of the ordinary because I usually feel lightheaded randomly and nauseous randomly. I'm not sure what's up with that. But so I was feeling a little bit off, and I noticed at like 11 days past ovulation that I hadn't started spotting yet. And I only have a 13-day luteal phase, and so I should have started spotting to like indicate that my period was coming. And so I just kind of took note mentally, like, oh, that's weird, I'm not spotting yet. So the next morning, I woke up and I took a pregnancy test, and it was positive. 12 days past ovulation, and it was positive. I can't believe it. It's still so surreal that I'm having this conversation with you guys. It's just so weird. But yeah, so that, I guess, you know, how some people have implantation spotting, and that is like their clue or an early pregnancy symptom, you know, for them to have that spotting. My actual, one of my first signs was actually my lack of spotting, so that's kind of backwards and fitting for Jason and I guess. So yeah, so that day I went to the doctor. I got an appointment, which was really great that I got in right away. But I didn't think they were going to give me a urine test in the office, so I peed before I went to the appointment, and of course, they gave me a urine test there in the office, and it came back negative. So I was just like, oh my god, did I hallucinate those positives? You know, I'm freaking out at this point, thinking, oh shit, maybe I'm not really pregnant and I'm getting all excited for nothing. So she's like, okay, well it's negative, but you could just be earlier than you think, so I'm going to send you to get some blood work done, and we will see what your HCG level is. I'm like, great. My first beta. I could not be more excited. So I literally left the doctor's office, went and got my blood done. This was at probably, I got out of the blood collection place at, I want to say like 2:20 in the afternoon. I went back to work and I got a call from the doctor's office around 3:30 letting me know that my results were in and that my first beta was 31. So that was great. A really, really solid number for 12 days past ovulation. Just, I was really happy with that number. So that was great, but I think they're used to seeing people a little bit later in their pregnancies. Like, maybe people usually don't find out till like 5 weeks and or 6 weeks before they actually get into the doctor and get their HCG checked. So they thought that number was low, which it actually isn't for 12 days past ovulation, but in any event, they wanted me to go back again, which is great, and that's actually not standard at the office that I go to. They usually just do one beta to confirm pregnancy, and then that's it. They don't check for progression, which I think is stupid, but nonetheless, that's what they did. So I was really happy when they wanted me to go for a second blood draw. So that was November 17th, was a Thursday, and then they wanted me to go back in that Monday, which was the 21st, to get my second beta, just to be sure that, you know, things were progressing, which was good. So I went in and had my blood taken, and then later on that night I got a call at home after I got home from work. It was the longest afternoon ever, sitting at work waiting for them to call, and then they didn't, and I was like, oh, I'm not gonna hear from them. But they called me at home, so that was really good. And so I'm on the phone, and so like they like your beta to double every 48 to 72 hours, so I was looking for a number, you know, 120, 130, you know, I would have been happy with that. I said to my parents and to my husband, I said, if they tell me 150, that's just going to be really great. You know, if they say 200, then that's just like, whoa, like super strong number. So they call me and let me know what my beta is. And it is 445. So my beta is actually doubling every 25 hours. Which is really good. And before you go jumping to twins, it's twins. Yes, that thought has already run through my mind, but it's not abnormal for singleton pregnancies to double that fast either. So we're hoping that it is just one strong little bean, although if it's two, we will be thrilled with that as well. We're going to take whatever is given to us at this point. So, but yeah, and I think that's all the betas that I'm going to get. Usually they don't do anymore unless there's like some sign of, you know, miscarriage or something like that, then they'll do betas again to see if your numbers are still going up. But I think that's all I'm going to get. I went back for more blood work after that on, I think I went on Thursday. I don't know what the date is of that day, but just this past Thursday. And I had all of my prenatal blood work done. So all the stuff that they check for that, I'm not even sure what they check for that. And I gave a urine sample as well. And then this coming Tuesday will be my first prenatal appointment. So that is super, super exciting. So today I'm 5 weeks exactly. So 5 weeks, 1 day, 2 days, 5 weeks, 3 days, I'll have my first prenatal. So that's really exciting. Could not be more excited. But yeah, 445, like that's just a crazy number. That's a crazy number, but very good nonetheless. All right, so symptoms that I've been having. A lot of these symptoms just happened the past day or like three days, 2 days ago I started getting symptoms. My food does not taste good. Nothing tastes good, actually. It's not that it makes me feel nauseous. It's just that it just, I don't want it. I feel hungry, but I just don't feel like eating. Nothing. At all. And stuff that I usually love to eat, I find tastes weird now, which is great. So I've actually lost weight. I started out at 122 was my starting weight pre-pregnancy, and I'm down to 120 already. So that's a little bit concerning. Not, you know, I don't want to lose a whole bunch of weight, obviously, because I don't feel like being sick, but I'm hoping that you know, that'll correct itself and I'll get my appetite back. But for now, I don't have an appetite and food just tastes gross. The only thing that I like right now is Del Monte fruit punch in like the squincher packages. I don't think I have one close by. They're delicious. And I go through like 6 or 7 of them a day. They're just so good. And they're so cold and I don't know what it is, but I just really like it. I'm not sure if that's a craving exactly, because I think it's just too early for that. But nonetheless, I really like the fruit punch, but I don't like anything else. I am tired all day pretty well. I get like spurts where I have energy, but for the most part, I'm just tired. I've been going to bed at like 7:15 on work nights just because I can't stay awake and I just don't feel the need to. But the on the flip side of that is I can't sleep in. Today's Saturday, and usually on a Saturday, I'll, you know, sleep until 11 or 12, you know. I love to sleep, but today I got up at 7:30 and I just could not fall back asleep. There was just, couldn't fall asleep. So that really sucks, because I just love my sleep. And I figure now's the time to get the sleep in, because, you know, once, you know, I have a baby, I'm not going to be able to sleep again, ever, or so I hear. What else? I've been having some cramping. I guess that's normal. I'm hoping that it's just a little bean nestling in. It does worry me sometimes, but, you know, I'm sure any one of you who've experienced cramping, in early pregnancy has probably been a little bit freaked out. And especially, you know, those who've had miscarriages, before getting pregnant again. Cramping scares the hell out of me, but I have had no spotting at all, and I check every single time I pee just because I'm petrified, but no spotting, but I am having some cramping, and it's like kind of off and on, but it's not like period cramps, but it's there, so that sucks as well. And the last sort of symptom that I'm having is bloating. I'm really bloated right now. Not to the point where my pants don't fit or anything like that, but, you know, just kind of, I just feel full, I guess. full is the way that I can describe it, but yeah, I definitely feel bloated, and that's just not fun. But it comes with the territory. And the thing is, like, I'm telling you all of these symptoms, and they suck. Like, having bad symptoms suck, and people who say that people, you know, who are pregnant, who, like, tried to conceive for so long and then finally get pregnant and then complain about their pregnancy and their symptoms, I think that's absolutely crazy, because, like, the symptoms suck. But I woke up the other night at 3:30 in the morning. I don't know what night it was. I think it was Wednesday, well, like, Thursday morning at 3 a.m. I woke up, and I was nauseous. I was so nauseous, and I did not like that I felt nauseous, but in the back of my mind, I'm thinking, that's good. Because I don't know why, like, feeling nauseous is, like, good. But you know what I mean. Like, you're excited to feel symptoms, and, but that doesn't mean that they're fun. So I probably will not complain about symptoms, but I'm gonna tell you when they suck, because they do. They do suck. And I think that I'm allowed to say that they suck, even though I'm so happy that I have them in the same breath. Do you know what I mean? So I hope that doesn't offend anybody, but that's just how I feel. So yeah, that's pretty well it. I just wanna, like, say a huge thank you to everyone. I've gotten a bunch new subscribers, so thanks, new subscribers, for subscribing and tuning in. Really excited to do these. I hope to be able to do them every Saturday, because that's when my weeks turn over. So yeah, that's it for week 5, and week 4, I guess, all of it combined into one, and I will see you again next week for week 6, which is another huge milestone. I don't know why. Each week is going to be a huge milestone. I'm just so excited and just thrilled and overjoyed, and I just cannot believe that this is happening finally. It's just so surreal. All of you who are still trying to conceive, I had someone ask me on my Facebook, you know, what does it feel like? You know, I hope that I can feel what you're feeling sometime, you know, because she's still trying to conceive. And it's amazing, the feeling. It's fear, and it's joy, and it's nerves, and it's excitement, and it's everything just all rolled into one big emotion, and it's amazing. And even though it's scary, and I am afraid of what might happen still, I still wish it on all of you who are still trying to conceive, and it's just amazing. And I'm sorry that I'm getting emotional, but I guess I'm pregnant and I'm allowed. But I still feel like I'm on the other side, still trying to conceive, because it's just so surreal to think that I'm over here. I'm sorry. It's just so surreal to think that I'm actually pregnant and I'm telling you my symptoms. I just can't believe it. So we'll just leave it at that. I'm gonna pick up the tripod right now because I really don't want to edit. We're gonna take a walk and I'm gonna show you my belly. Bear in mind, I don't have a flat tummy like some of you girls are lucky to have. It's not super not flat, but in any event, I will show you my belly. I do want to keep track of growth and all that, so let's go check out the belly. Don't be mad at me for getting emotional. It's just because I'm pregnant. Okay, ooh, that's a shot. All right. So, I'm going to shut this door. And shut this. Alright. So this is my belly at 5 weeks. I have a little, well, it's not much, but I was hoping to, I was going to start P90X in January, but I wanted a stomach, I wanted a six pack. But I guess I won't be doing that now. So, yeah. Set this down for a second. Let's see if I can just use that like that. Oh, that's great. All right. So this is week 5. Not too bad. A little bit bloated. Not sure if you can hear that in the background, but we have put up some Christmas decorations and the clock is going off and it's got Christmas carols going. So yeah, that is my 5-week belly. I'm with the shirt again. Yeah. Anyways, I love you girls so much. Thank you so much for tuning in, and I will see you next week at 6 weeks. All right. Bye.